everybody, welcome back to Exotic Astrology, ladies and gentlemen. And the other day somebody had asked me a question, like always, and I was amazed. The person asked me, what exactly does Saturn represent? Well, we know Saturn represents so many things. It represents big things, sometimes dangerous things, as they say. But what exactly does Saturn represent? In one word, if you want to understand that, of course we will see from many angles what Saturn represents. Okay, so if you are new to the channel and if you have not yet subscribed to it, then please subscribe to it. And if you want a consultation, and if you want to know how your Saturn is placed or where your Saturn is or how Saturn is affecting you, then you can go to my website. You will find the link of the website in the description of this video, and you can book a one-to-one reading with me. All right. And before I begin, as I always say, God is there with you all the time. Just look to Him and you will find Him. Okay. So the other day I was asked, what exactly Saturn represents? Well, the answer is very simple. Saturn represents... should I tell it now? No. Let's go from the backside. See, they say that Saturn signifies those areas which give us suffering. Those areas which give us pain. Why do they say that? Why? Have you ever thought of it? Try to think. Otherwise, we will stay here only. Try to think. Why that happens? Because Saturn represents those areas in our chart where we like to run away from. Should I repeat? Saturn represents those things which we love to ignore, which we do not like to attend to. It represents those areas of our life. For example, if Saturn is placed in a particular house, or it is conjunct a particular planet, or it is aspecting a particular planet, then those things related to that house or that planet will give us some level of suffering. Now, depending on the dignity of Saturn, dignity means how Saturn is placed. Saturn itself is placed in which house? Which sign is it? Which planets are aspecting Saturn? Is Saturn also been afflicted by Sun, Mars, Rahu or Ketu? Or is Saturn been aspected by a great benefic like Jupiter or Venus? Or Mercury or Moon? Yes? And so many other things are there to calculate dignity. What houses is Saturn ruling in the chart? So, depending on the dignity, the places which Saturn is impacting. Impacting means Saturn is sitting in one house, then it will aspect one particular house from its third aspect, then from its seventh, then from its tenth aspect. Okay, that will vary depending on the dignity, or some planet will be sitting in these houses. That means to the level which suffering is there will vary on the dignity of Saturn. But the question is, why at all is the suffering coming from there? Because we are not addressing those issues from many lifetimes. Why? I don't know, because maybe we don't like to address them. So for example, suppose Saturn is sitting in any house you take. Suppose it's sitting in the Lagna itself. Okay. So whenever Saturn is sitting in the Lagna, we are not cultivating how to direct our intelligence to a proper place, because Lagna shows intelligence. Yes, dhi, that's the word which is used. Dhi is intelligence. Where should we direct our intelligence? And intelligence does not mean here, oh, how quickly you can understand mathematics or how quickly you can understand geography, chemistry. No, that is not intelligence. That is a part of intelligence. But when I say intelligence, I am saying how to use our human brain, that faculty that we are not addressing. We are using it in unnecessary things. That is what happens when Saturn sits in the Lagna. Of course, it will depend on so many other things. And then from there, it will aspect the third house. It will aspect the seventh house. And it will also aspect the tenth house of career. Okay. So anyways. So the thing is, wherever Saturn is sitting and whichever houses it is aspecting, you will always notice. Take your own chart. Open your own chart. And you see where Saturn is sitting. And then you just have a reality check related to that house. Okay, you will always see that related to that house, you will get a voice inside which will tell you, you are not doing this which you should do. Pow, 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 pow. Always the alarm will be ringing there inside you. And people keep telling me, oh, what Saturn will do here, what Saturn will do there. Well, it's very simple. Check where Saturn is sitting. You know the significations of every house. Suppose Saturn is in the second house, you know what second house is. Suppose Saturn is in the eighth house, you know what eighth house is. You know what is tenth house, you know what is ninth house. And if somebody is thinking that this is like alien language, they don't know what I'm speaking, then you have to go to my basics astrology playlist and you have to watch all these videos and you have to know about the zodiac signs and the houses and the significations of this of the different planets. Otherwise you may not understand what I'm saying here. So you know which house Saturn is sitting, okay? So just ask yourself this question: is everything clear in that house? You will get a different answer which you do not like to hear. At least for me it is like that. I don't know for others. Yes, so people with Saturn in the sixth house, always problem with work, with discipline, zero discipline in life. Now they say that, oh, Saturn in the sixth is very good for discipline. Why in the universe do they say that? Because that's the area where you need discipline the most. I mean, sixth house is the house of discipline, and when you have Saturn there, it's like saying you have not cultivated discipline from many lifetimes, and so it will show the rod and it will hit you. And then you say, oh yes, I have become very disciplined now. You see, now you understand why they say malefics are good in the sixth house. Anyways, today's topic is not malefics in the sixth house. So suppose Saturn is conjunct Venus, oh my god, or Saturn is aspecting Venus, you will always find these people, they are the most irresponsible people when coming to relationships. Now somebody will write in the comments, oh, my Saturn is with Venus, it has been, it's aspecting Venus, you are lying, you are a cheater, you are a thug, you don't know what you speak, you are creating fear, you are creating terror, you want money for consultations and readings. Well, you must see the whole chart. Okay, millions of people will have Saturn Venus conjunction and so many other things which I say in this video, but you have to see the whole chart. So generally they say that Saturn and Venus, if they are connected, that there is suffering in marriage relationships. Yes, and I have seen so many charts, I have seen so many charts where that holds true. But the question is, why? Why have you asked this question? You will just say, oh, Saturn is aspecting Venus, oh, my Venus is finished. No, if you understand where the problem is, you will understand how to solve it. The problem with Saturn is people will always tell you what Saturn will, how Saturn will fear you, how Saturn will give you terror, but they will not tell you how to solve the problem. So if Saturn is having any link with Venus, which means if it is conjunct or aspecting Venus, we will always see that whenever we think in the area of relationships, we will always get a question mark inside. Yes, because Saturn is the karaka for indifference. Indifference means, as in Hindi they say na, bhaad mein ja, mujhe farak nahi padta. It's that yogi type mentality. That's what Saturn is. So when we behave like that with our opposite partner, we have been doing that in many lifetimes. Because of that, now Saturn is telling, look, now you have to get suffering in that area. So how to cure that? We should be a very responsible person when it comes to relationships. For example, so many people tell me these days, oh, my mother is not agreeing to marrying this girl, nah? This her father is not agreeing, this is not happening, that is not happening. Well, you celebrate honeymoon first and then you are like, oh yeah, we got to marry also, and you think that nothing will happen. No, that's not the way it works. If you have indulged in physical pleasure, you must take responsibility. That has to happen. When you don't do that, you will get suffering. There's no denial of that fact. And that's what you see what is happening these days. People are hopping from one person to the other and then after 35 they are like, oh, we don't want to marry, forget it. So when we behave like this irresponsibly in those areas, then we cannot complain that Saturn is punishing us. It is insane to do like that. Suppose Saturn is sitting with Moon, then we let our emotions. Now see, Saturn and Moon conjunction, they say it is Vish Yoga. Why do they say that? Have you ever thought? Vish Yoga, poison it is, like deadly poison. Very dangerous word, right? Vish Yoga. Why do they say that? Because when Saturn and Moon are conjunct, or their Moon is being aspected by Saturn, the person has a tendency to let the mind keep flowing like anything. As Srimad Bhagavatam says, Mano Rathe Nasati Dhavato Bahi. It means that Mano Ratha means the chariot of the mind is hovering. Mano Rathe Nasati Dhavato Bahi. Bahi means too many. Oh, let me just sit and think idle, be idle. Oh, maybe I can go to Paris, maybe I'll do a master's in Germany, maybe I will do this here, maybe I'll do that there. If you let your mind wander like this, then what happens? Ideal mind is a devil's workshop. Then all the negativity comes. Yes, the moment you get up, what you do? Oh, let's check Facebook. Who is getting married, who is having an affair, who changed their relationship status from single to committed to single to married, or single to engaged, or from married to divorced. Yes, let's check that, right? And then, oh, let's check LinkedIn.com. Who got promotion? Who got a new job? That is what you are doing. Let's check the display pictures of the girls in my WhatsApp. Yes, let's do that. And if you're a girl, then the same you might do for a man. So when you are just letting your mind do whatever it wants, then you say it's Vish Yoga. Yes, it is Vish Yoga, because then your mind will not let you be in peace. It will always tell you, oh look, that person is happy, she is happy, he is happy, you are not happy, the problem is with you. No, the problem is not, it's not with others, it is inside you, that you are not able to control your mind. And Lord Krishna says in the Gita that the uncontrolled mind is the most deadliest enemy of the mankind. Yes, Krishna says lust is the biggest enemy. And when does lust attack us? When the mind is uncontrolled. Yes, we are thinking of the opposite sex 24 hours. Why? Because we are letting the mind to go like that. Instead, let us think about God. Then the problems will be quite less, right? Now somebody will write in the comments, oh, what's the problem in thinking about the opposite sex? No problem, I keep thinking I am happy. So when we let the mind wander recklessly without any restriction, then you see, we suffer. Then they say it's Vish Yoga. Why not? Why it will not be Vish Yoga? Use your common sense, man. If you are not doing things which you should be doing, and you are just thinking and imagining that the world will change and things will turn around magically one day. No, it's not going to happen. Like many times when I do consultations, people tell me, not many, but sometimes people tell me that, oh, please give me one magic mantra which will change everything. And then I'm like, if you find it, tell me also. There has been no magic mantra, there is no magic mantra, and there will be no magic mantras. Okay? Suppose Saturn is aspecting the 10th house. Highly irresponsible when it comes to career and work. The most irresponsible workers you will find. Yes? If the whole chart is bad, of course. Now somebody will say, oh, that billionaire has Saturn in the 4th, in the Lagna, in the 10th, in the 8th, because from these places it is impacting the 10th house. Well, you have to see the whole chart. Of course, but I have seen in my experience that when you have Saturn linked with the 10th house, the most highly irresponsible people I have seen. Why? Now they say that, oh, Saturn will give you suffering there in the 10th house. Yes, you will not get name and fame. Why? Because you are not working, how will you get it? Or suppose you are working, and then some people say, oh, my Saturn is in the 10th, I am working, but still there is nothing appearing in the sky. Why? In my life, why is it happening? Because in your past lifetimes, you have tried to pull somebody down. Now you are finding it very, 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 very difficult to go up the ladders of corporate or politics or whatever it is. Okay? And suppose Saturn is conjunct or aspecting Sun, then the same things can happen. Problems with authority figures. Why? Have you asked this question? Why? Because we behave irresponsibly sometimes. We break laws, we break rules, and then we expect that the authority will protect us. Doesn't happen like that. Everything is very intricately designed. even if you break the signal of the traffic once, you will get karma for that. Take it in writing if you do it. You may not like to hear this, you may dislike this video, I don't care, but I'm still saying, if you break the traffic signal, you will get karma. Okay, you will definitely get it. If you bitch about somebody, pardon my language, I should not be using this word, but I'm still saying, if you speak ill about somebody, you will get the karma back one day. Sometimes people tell me, why do I always run into scandals? Yes, now you understand. Because you were speaking badly about somebody someday. Now Saturn is telling, look, you behave irresponsibly. Now, get it. Especially if Saturn and Mercury are linked. Always that happens, you will see. Saturn, Mercury conjunct or aspecting each other or Saturn aspecting Mercury. You will always see this. At least I have seen in my experience. The moment they will open their mouth, criticism. Oh, you know, that person is good for nothing. Bekar hai, kisi kaam ka nahi hai. Useless hai ekdam. He's useless actually. No, good for nothing. And who are you? You are Raja Ramchandra, right? You are the great Lord Ram. Yes, that's who you are, right? You think yourself to be so great. You think that you are so great that nobody should do anything wrong to you. Which means that you think that everybody should be perfect. Why? Because I am perfect, right? Because I sleep on time, I don't do anything wrong. Yes, I am the best person that has ever stayed and that Lord Brahma can ever create. So then they say that, oh, Saturn Mercury is giving me problems in friendships, in communications, dealing with other people. Why do they say that? Because we are behaving irresponsibly towards that area. Then the repercussions will come, you see. Yes, I can go on and on taking examples. Jupiter, Saturn, Mars, so many things. But that's not important. The thing is, you already know what planets signify, what houses are, what conjunctions are. You all know that. I don't have to go to practically each and every area and keep giving the analysis here. But today, if you have watched this video fully, just sit down and look at your chart. And then you see where Saturn is sitting. Which other planets it is throwing its aspect and houses. Just meditate for 2 minutes and ask yourself, is everything clear regarding that house? If you get an answer no, please clear it now itself. So for example, if Saturn is sitting in your 7th house and you ask yourself, oh, is everything fine in my marriage? No man, there's some problem. What that problem is, solve it now. Do your best to solve it. And there are so many remedies for Saturn which is flooded, which are good actually, which are in one way they are from the scriptures only, but they cannot help you. For example, I have seen some remedies which sometimes seem very funny to me. For example, there was one remedy for Saturn I saw, somebody had told, oh, walking on Saturdays. Now yes, that walking is a remedy for Saturn, and walking on Saturdays is also a very big remedy for Saturn. I know that, but till the time you do not address that voice inside to whichever houses Saturn is sitting or impacting, you keep walking for thousands and millions of miles on Saturdays, on all the 7 days. You keep giving donations to poverty stricken people who are represented by Saturn. You keep donating things on Saturdays or in the hora of Saturn. It will not give you any result, I'm telling you. Well, if that would be true, then anybody who would do wrong things, they would just go and keep giving money, right? If suppose somebody does something wrong to you, and then that person comes and says, oh, I'll just give you this money, will you forgive me? What will you say? At least I will not forgive the person. If the person begs forgiveness that I am sorry, I will not repeat this again, then I may forgive. Yes? And everybody will forgive them if the person is repenting from inside. But suppose a man goes and rapes a woman and he says, don't worry, I'll give you $1 million. What do you think the girl will say? Get lost. You'll be hanged. Yes, that's what is going to happen to you. So if we do not address the voice which is inside us pertaining to the areas of Saturn, then we will have to continually suffer in this world. And how to do that? We have to sit down and meditate and write, take a pen and a paper and write okay, my Saturn is in this house. Just do this simple 5 minutes exercise today. 5 minutes exercise. No big video on Sade Sati, this, that, nothing is required. Just sit down and you do this small homework. By this, you will know what the problems are there in your horoscope, okay? Sit down and write. Okay, Saturn is in this house. Is everything fine? No. Then go and check it. Alright? And now, Saturn also represents discipline. So, discipline is very, very, very important to whichever houses Saturn is sitting or whichever houses it is ruling, okay? So, be disciplined, lead a disciplined life. And how do you do that? You have to be in the mode of goodness, sattva guna, to have discipline. A person who is in Rajo Guna or Tamo Guna cannot have discipline. Zero discipline. It's in minus, hands down. So, Sattva Guna is required for discipline. And what Sattva Guna represents? Sattva Guna represents the highest level of the functioning, which we can, as they say, working at your best version. That's what Sattva Guna is. And how do we cultivate Sattva Guna? By getting up early in the morning. Very, 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 very important. Whoever says get up at 4 o'clock in the evening, it doesn't work. You have to get up early. Yes. Then getting up early and taking a bath early in the morning in cold water. I am saying again and again and again, and I am simply repeating. Yes, taking bath in cold water early in the morning. Very important, you see. Then sitting down and chanting mantras. After you chant mantras, read the scriptures, read Bhagavad Gita shloka, one shloka per day, that's it, enough, nothing else is needed. Or take out the Srimad Bhagavatam and read, or take out the Brahma Samhita and read. If you do this, your intelligence will be clear. You will be able to understand yourself more better. You will know where the problem is. And once you do that, during the day, avoid doing wrong activities, unnecessary activities. Like many of you have messaged me that you used to watch pornography earlier, but now after seeing my videos, you are not watching. I'm very happy to hear it. Feels great to know that somebody is getting benefited by your videos. Anyways, so if you are drinking, then please try to reduce it and eventually give it up. If you are eating meat, no, try to reduce it and eventually you will give it up, okay? And if you are into gambling, then stop it directly. Everything is out. And take good association of people, which means that only associate with those people who give positivity. Anywhere you are seeing gossip, stay away from that place. Even if you stay totally away from a circle, it is better to be like that rather than staying somewhere where there is gossip going on, just to stay with people, okay? And then when you come in the night, in the evening, you can also recite some shlokas, you can also read the scriptures for 5 minutes, and then go to bed early. By 9:30, 10 o'clock, get in the bed and get up early in the morning and do the chanting of the mantras again, alright? And in the weekends, go and associate in a nearby spiritual center, spiritual retreat in your city or in your town, in your village or in your state or in your district, wherever it is. Okay, and when you go there, ask questions on spirituality about your origin and the creation of this universe and all other divine topics, as it is said, Athato Brahma Jigyasa. Inquire about the higher truth, alright, and take prasad in the temple, which is the bhoga which is offered to God, and then always maintain good relation with your guru and your god brothers and your family members, of course. By this, lead a disciplined life, and then by that you will see Saturn will not trouble you that much. Hopefully, okay. There you go. If you like this video, then click the thumbs up and share it with somebody who is too much concerned with what Saturn will do or what Saturn has already done. Alright, so there you go. If you're new to the channel and if you have not yet subscribed, then please subscribe to it. And if you want a consultation, then please approach me through my website. The link is there in the description below. Okay, and before ending, as I say, God is there with you all the time. Just look to Him and He will help you, and He will help you identify the areas which Saturn is telling you to improve in this life. Okay, until next time, wish you good luck. Bye bye. See you.